ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतानः शृण्वन्मोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम् डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् इन् द मिडल् आफ् दिस् भाष्यम्, द कन्क्लूडिङ्ग् भाष्यम् आफ् श्री शङ्कराचार्य इन् दि 18th चाप्टर् आफ् गीता। सो द काण्टेक्स्ट् विच् वी वर् ऐ थिङ्क् दिस् भाष्यं विल् कण्टिन्यू फार् टू मोर् डेस्, टुडे, टुमारो अण्ड् आल्सो डे आफ्टर्. By day after tomorrow, I think we'll be able to complete this Bhashyam. Because the language is rather tough, we are going slowly. So, in the last class, we were reading this line, Dehadi Sanghate Aham Pratyayaha Gaunaha Namithya Iti Chet Na Tat Karyeshwapi Gaunatvo Papattehe. I think we read that.
Yes.
So, the context is, the Purvapakshi is saying, you see, Dehadi Sanghate Aham Pratyayaha. You see, this considering this body-mind complex as I, the notion of I in the body-mind complex, that is something which is gauna. We are only figuratively calling it like that, it is not in reality. So that is what he is saying. And earlier also he said, don't think that you are the only person who knows, we also know. So that is what he said earlier also. So in the same way he is saying, they have this notion of I in this body-mind complex is rather figurative. It is not real. So that is what he says. Then the Siddhanti says, Na tat karyeshwapi gaunatvapapattehe. If you say like that, the karya also should be gauna. Karyam is not gauna. Suppose you say dehadi sanghata, okay, this aham pratyaya is something which is figurative. And then with this aham pratyaya, you are doing some yajna, you are doing something else. You are doing some punya karma and some papa karma. But the phalam is coming. That phalam is not gauna. Phala is something which is real. So that is what he is going to explain. First he is going to explain the Purvapaksha. Then again he is going to explain the Siddhanta. Reply. So the Purvapaksha he is explaining. Atmiye dehadi sanghate aham pratyaya. Did we read this line?
Yeah, completed.
Completed also. Anyway, I'll read it fast and then explain. Atmiye dehadi sanghate aham pratyaya gaunaha. यथा आत्मीये पुत्रे आत्मा वै पुत्रनामासीति. सो इन दिस बॉडी माइंड कॉम्प्लेक्स दिस नोशन ऑफ आई इज समथिंग गौण. जस्ट एज इन द केस ऑफ आत्मा वै पुत्रनामासी, यू एग्जिस्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ युवर सन. आत्मा वै पुत्रनामा असि, त्वम आत्मा, आत्मा मीन्स त्वम, पुत्रनामा असि, यू आर एग्जिस्टिंग इन द शेप ऑफ युवर सन. सो दट इज इन दट मैनर पुत्रनामासी. लोकेशापि मम प्राण एव अयं गौः इति. ओ दिस बुल आर दिस कौ इज मै प्राण. दिस इज लाइक मै प्राण, नॉट लाइक मै प्राण, दिस इज मै प्राण. सो दट वे इन अ फिगरेटिव वे वी आर सी यूजिंग इट. अहम प्रत्यय गौण यथा देन गौरीति नैवं मिथ्या प्रत्यय. इट वाट वी से इज नॉट मिथ्या प्रत्यय. You are saying that we are having this false perception. I say that it is not false perception. We are deliberately saying it in a figurative way, he says. And the Purvapakshi is also explaining that how Mithya Pratyaya arises and how Gauna Pratyaya arises. So he is explaining a difference. Mithya Pratyayastu Sthana Purushayoho Apurushayoho Agruhyamana Visheshayoho. Suppose Mithya Pratyaya, when does it arise? Mithya pratyaya means false understanding, false perception. In some semi-dark condition, you see some sort of stump there, and then you think whether you are in a doubt whether it is a person or a log or something like that, a stump of the tree. So then you may mistake a stump of a tree for a human being. So that sort of thing, agruhyamana vishesha yoho, where you are not able to perceive them properly. Agruhyamana means not properly perceived. Vishesha yoho, when the vishesha or the uniqueness or the speciality or that say the nature, exact nature of it is not properly perceived, then mithya pratyaya can arise. But whereas we are deliberately calling, we are using it as a sort of Gauna Pratyaya. What does Siddhanti say? Siddhanti says, if you have to say that Gauna, it is Gauna Pratyaya, the result also should be Gauna. Whereas result is not Gauna. So that is what he is explaining now. Na Gauna Pratyayasya Mukhya Karyarthatvam. So see, if you say it is Gauna Pratyaya, then Gauna Pratyaya will not produce a Mukhya Karyam. Whereas, whatever you are doing in the name of Gauna Pratyaya, it is producing a Mukhya Karyam. You Mukhya Phalam. Mukhya Phalam or Mukhya Karyam. Mukhya Karyam and Phalam, we can use it synonymously here. So, Mukhya Karyarthatvam is seen. But Gauna Pratyaya should not be like that. Gauna Pratyayasya na Mukhya Karyarthatvam. Adhikarana stutyarthatvat luptopama shabdena.
Adhikarana stutyarthatvat
luptopama shabdena. Luptopama. Luptopama. Upama, you know.
Simile.
Simile. Your face is like the moon. You say, your face is like the moon. So there, face is something which is adhikarana. Adhikarana means that which is being, that which is the subject matter. Adhikarana is subject, adharo adhikaranam. Grammar says adharo adhikaranam. Your face is the moon. The face is the adhikarana. Moon is something which has been compared, isn't it? Then is like, is the upama vachaka. Upama vachaka means that is the statement of equality, it is statement of similarity. So that statement of similarity, suppose it is missing. It is called luptopama. Lupta means where something is missing. Lopa. Lopa. Lopa, you know the word lopa. Lopa means something which is absent. Lopaha. Varna lopaha. So lopa means something which is missing. Lupta means that upama vachaka is missing there. Luptopama, instead of saying your face is like a moon, you say this is your face is moon. So here also simho manavakaha, this boy is a lion. So there is a figurative usage, isn't it? That this boy is a lion, this boy is fire, agnir manavakaha, simho devadattaha. These are where it is a luptopama. So with this luptopama is being used only to adhikarana stutyarthatvam. Adhikarana. Adhikarana is whatever is the subject matter there. That subject matter is that boy, whoever is that boy. You are praising him, giving a pat on the back, saying that, oh, he is like a lion. So that is it. Adhikarana stutyarthatva luptopama shabdena.
Yatha simho devadattaha.
Agnir manavakaha iti. So you are saying, oh, this Devadatta. Devadatta is just a general name. So and so X, he is a lion. Then Agnir Manavakaha. Manavaka means this student, this boy, he is Agni, he is like fire, he is a fire brand, we say. So this fellow is a fire brand. Then Simha Iva Agniriva. Krauriya Paingalyadi Samanyatvat. Devadatta Manavika Adhikarana Stutyarthameva. Natu Simha Karyam Agni Karyam Va. Gauna Shabda Pratyaya Nimittam Kinchit Sadhyate. Mithya Pratyaya Karyatvam Tu Kariyam Tu also is okay. Karyatvam Tu Anartham Anubhavati. Okay. Here is explaining. Where did it start? Simhaiva Agniriva. Okay. Krauriya Paingalyadi. Okay. Agnir Manavakaiti. Simhaiva Agniriva. Like this Simha or like that Agni. Krauriya Paingalyadi Samanyavat. So this Simha is the similarity between Simha is Krauryam. Then this like Agni. Agni means Paingalya, that yellowishness, yellowish color. Pingala Varnam, you know. Pingala Varnam is that yellowish color, yellow color. So that sort of fire brand, he is probably when he gets angry, he becomes like that yellowishness, yellowish face. So then, because of that, Devadatta Manavakadhikarana Stutyarthameva. Devadatta or Manavaka. Devadatta is some X, Manavaka is some student. They are the Adhikarana. They are the subject matter there. Stutyarthameva. Tayoho Stutyarthameva. That is in order to just praise them or compliment them. Natu Simhakaryam Agnikaryam va Sadhyate. That is, it is not as though these people are going and fighting like those lions. Or the other fellow is not going like Agni and then burning something, scorching something. Natu Simhakaryam Agnikaryam va. Simhakaryam is the real deed of a Simha. The Simha goes and fights with another Simha. This boy is not going to fight with another Simha. Nor is this student going and scorching something. Simhakaryam Agnikaryam va. Gauna Shabda Pratyaya Nimittam Kinchis Sadhyate. Because of that Gauna Shabda, Gauna Pratyaya, you are not going to achieve the real impact. But here, what is happening? Here, Mithya Pratyaya Karyatvam Tu, your book says Karyam Tu, that is also okay. Mithya Pratyaya Karyam Tu, Anartham Anubhavati. So this Mithya Pratyaya Karyam, you are saying it is Gauna Pratyaya, we say it is Mithya Pratyaya because you are doing something. And that thing is giving you a result. And that result is something which is real. Mithya Pratyaya Karyam Tu, Anartham. Anartham is something which is undesirable, unwanted thing. What is that? Samsara. You see, you do some good work, you go to heaven, dance for some time and then come back. You do some bad work, go to some hell, get some whiplashes and come back. So this is the anartha, isn't it? Whether it is hell or heaven, both are anartha. So that is it. Anartham Anubhavati. Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam Cha Janati.
Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam Cha Janati.
Naisha Simhaha Devadatta Syat.
Naisha Simhaha Devadatta Syat.
Nayam Agnihi Manavakaha Iti.
Nayam Agnihi Manavakaha Iti.
Okay, Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam. Vishayam means the subject matter, the subject which has been referred to in a metaphorical way. That is that Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam. Gauna Pratyaya is that metaphorical figurative usage and figurative understanding. Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam, that particular object or person, here it is person. Gauna Pratyaya Vishayam tu, Vishayam cha, Janati, Naisha Simhaha, Naisha Devadattaha. We know, he is not Simha. Naisha Simhaha Devadattaha. This fellow is Devadatta, not certainly Simha. Then Nayam Agnihi Manavakahiti. This fellow is not fire, but only student. We know. Tatha Gaunena Dehadi Sanghatena Atmana Kurtam Karma.
Gaunena Devadi Sanghatena Atmana Kurtam Karma.
Dehadi Sanghatena Atmana. That is, Gaunena has to be connected to Atmana. Gaunena Atmana Dehadi Sanghatena. So words you have to rephrase like that. Gaunena Atmana Dehadi Sanghatena. So this Dehadi Sanghata is treated by you as Gaunatma. So the two words you please remember, Gaunatma and Mukhyatma. Gauna Mithyatma, sorry. Gaunatma, Mithya Mukhyatma also is okay. Mukhyatma is different, Gaunatma is different and Mithyatma is different. So here, Tatha Gaunena Dehadi Sanghatena Atmana. So you have to connect this Gaunena with Atmana. Gaunena Atmana Dehadi Sanghatena Kurtam Karma. Na Mukhyena Aham Pratyaya Vishayena Atmana Kurtam Syat.
Aham Pratyaya Vishayena Atmana Kurtam Syat.
Okay. So here, some activity which is done by this Gauna Karma, it cannot be said to be done as done by Mukhya Karma, Mukhya Atma. Suppose Gauna Atma does something, you cannot equate it with something which has been done by the Mukhya Atma. Mukhya Atma is something different and Gauna Atma is something different. He is explaining it in the next line. Nahi Gauna Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Karma.
Nahi Gauna Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Karma.
Mukhya Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Syat.
Mukhya Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Syat.
So the work which is done by this Devadatta or Manavaka, they are the Gauna Simhas, isn't it? Yeah. Gauna Simha and Gauna Agni. Nahi Gauna Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Karma, some activity which has been either done by Devadatta or by this Madhavaka, cannot be called as the same as done something which is done by the Mukhya Simha and Mukhya Agni. Mukhya Karma, Mukhya Simhagnibhyam Kurtam Karma Syat, Na Syat, that Na comes to here, Na Syat. Nacha Krauryena Paingalyena Va,
Nacha Krauryena Paingalyena Va,
Mukhya Simhagnyoha Karyam Kinchid Kriyate. स्तुत्यर्थेन उपक्षीणत्वात् स्तुत्यर्थेन ओके स्तुत्यर्थत्वेन स्तुत्यर्थत्वेन दैट इज बेटर आई थिंक स्तुत्यर्थेन दिस इज आल्सो ओके ग्रामेटिकली ओके न च क्रौर्येण पैंगल्येन वा बाय मेयरली बीइंग फेरोशस or by merely turning red when he becomes angry. Because of that, by these two things, mukhya simhagnyoha karyam na kinchit kriyate. By merely being ferocious, you are not going to fight with another lion. By merely turning red when you are angry, you are not going to burn all those things. So, mukhya karyam na kinchit kriyate. Nacha krauryena paingalyena va, by this krauryam and paingalyam, mukhya simhagnyoha karyam na kinchit kriyate. It is not achieved. Then, stutyarthena upachinatvat, that kravriyam, pinga, pavingalyam, etc., it is only to stutyartham, basically by way of complimenting, by way of praising, that's all. Stutyarthena upachinatvat, with that it is gone. With the upachinam means it is gone, it has disappeared. Stutyarthatmam, and then with that it has disappeared, and it is not going to produce the real work of a real simha or a real fire. So, that is the point. Then स्तूयमानौ च जानीतो नायं सिंहो नाहम अग्निः इति नाहम सिंहो नाहम अग्निरिति न सिंहस्य कर्म मम अग्नेश्च इति तथा न संघातस्य कर्म मम मुख्यस्य आत्मनः इति प्रत्ययः युक्ततरः स्यात् न पुनः अहं कर्ता मम कर्म इति सो द पॉइंट इज Dehadi Sangh, whatever has been done by this Dehadi Sanghata, this body-mind complex, it is not proper to think that it is done by Atma. Atma is something which is Akarta. It is improper to think that it is something which is done by Atma. All activity relates to Dehadi Sanghata. And whether you call it Gavana Pratyaya or whatever it is not Gavana Pratyaya. It is Mithya Pratyaya only. And whatever you do with this Dehadi Sanghata, you can't say that it is done by the Mukhyatma. So that is the thing which is mentioned. Stuyamanav cha janitaha. Stuyamanav means? Those two people who are being praised. Stuyamanaha. Stuyamanaha, Stuyamanav, Ramaharamav. Dvivachana. Stuyamanav cha janitaha. Those two people who are also being praised. Who? That Devadatta and Manavaka. Devadatta and Manavaka are the topic here. So those two people who are being praised, they also know, janitaha, they also know what? Naham simhaha naham agnihi iti. This fellow also knows I am not simha, the other fellow knows he is agni iti. Na simhasya karma mama agneshcha iti. Whatever simha does is not my karma, whatever agni does is not my karma iti. Tatha, likewise, na sanghatasya karma mama mukhyasya atmanaha iti pratyaya yukta hataraha syat. This type of understanding is logical. What? Yukta taraha. Yukti means logic. Yukta taraha means it is more logical, it is more appropriate to say that this sanghatasya karma is not my karma. Mukhyasya atmanaha. Mukhya atma is different from gaunatma. And if you are saying that this gaunatma, whatever is done, relates to mukhyatma, it is mithya pratyaya. It is your own wrong understanding, it is only your wrong perception. So, na sanghatasya karma mama mukhyasya atmanah iti pratyayaha. Pratyaya means understanding. Pratyayaha, that sort of understanding is yukta taraha. It is more logical. It is more logical to say that this sanghatasya karma is not my karma. Na punaha aham karta mama karma iti. Not otherwise. Not otherwise means it is not correct to say aham karta mama karma. It is something which is wrong. Then, yaccha ahuhu atmiyaihi smrutiiccha prayatnaihi karma hetubhihi atma karoti iti na tesham mithya pratyaya purvakatvat. So, here he is attached, this Purvapakshi is giving another argument. Yachya ahuhu. Some people say, some people may say, what is that? आत्मीयैहि स्मृति इच्छा प्रयत्नैहि. सो आत्मीयैहि मीन्स समथिंग दोस विच रिलेटिंग टू आत्मा. That is the attributes of Atma. These are the properties of Atma. They say, what are those? Smruti Ichha Prayatna. Smruti Ichha Prayatna ni Atma Gunani. Atma Gunani iti. To put in a normal sentence. See, Smruti is what? Recalling. Ichha. Ichha is desire. Prayatna means effort. Something you have seen, something you are recalling, and then you feel it is quite nice, and then you desire it, and then you go after it. So, smruti, icha, prayatna, they are atma dharmas, they say. They don't say that it is antahkarana dharma. We have come across all those things as antahkarana dharma. All these things, hrir, dhir, bhi, itiyadis, itiyata, sarvam, mana eva. Mana is antahkarana. He has dismissed all those chitta vruttis as belonging to antahkarana, and not to the atma. So, that is the point here. So, yachahu, some people say, atmiyehi smruti ichha pratyayehi prayatnaihi gunaihi. So, these are all atma guna, he says. So, then they say like that, with these things, karma hetu bhihi atma karoti iti. Karma hetu bhihi, these are these karma hetus, these are the cause, these are the motivating factors, hetu, karanam, that is the cause. These are the motivating factors for any karma. So, with these, Atma Karoti. So, that is what he says. Atma is the doer with the help of Smruti, Ichha, Prayatna. So, that is what they say. When they, if you say like that, Na. Tesham Mithya Pratyaya Purvakatva. It is all because of wrong understanding. Mithya Pratyaya Purvakatva means it is because of incorrect, false understanding. Then, Mithya Pratyaya Nimitta.
Mithya Pratyaya Nimitta.
Ishtanishtanubhuta. क्रियाफलजनित संस्कार पूर्विका पूर्वका ही
क्रियाफलजनित संस्कार पूर्वका ही
स्मृति इच्छा प्रयत्नादयः
स्मृति इच्छा प्रयत्नादयः.
So what exactly are these स्मृति इच्छा and प्रयत्न? These are all because of this मिथ्या प्रत्यय only. मिथ्या प्रत्यय निमित्त, that is something which is caused by this wrong understanding. This long thing I have broken, otherwise the line, the whole thing is one samasa. मिथ्याप्रत्ययेनिमित्तेष्ठानिष्ठानुभूतक्रियाफलजनितसंस्कारपूर्वक. द होल थिंग इज वन समास. सो दट इज वट वी हेव ब्रोकन. मिथ्याप्रत्यय निमित्त, दट इज दिस स्मृति इच्छा एंड ऑल्सो प्रयत्न, दीज आर कॉज्ड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मिथ्याप्रत्यय निमित्त. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मिथ्याप्रत्यय आर फॉल्स पर्सेप्शन. Then what is happening because of this false perception? You are developing some ichcha and dvesha, ishta and anishta. Ishta means something which is desired, anishta means something which is unwanted. Ishta anishta anubhuta, that those experiences you have experienced because of mithya pratyaya. Then, and that is again motivating you to some kriya. It is motivating you to some kriya. Kriya phala janita. Kriya, and that kriya is giving you some phalam. And that phalam is again giving you some samskara. Kriya, phala, janita, samskara. This is leading to one, leading to another. Kriya is leading to phalam. Phalam is giving you some experience, and that is giving you some samskara. Samskara means?
Impression.
Some impression, so that indelible impression in the mind, some predisposition, some disposition you can call, or predisposition or impression, whatever you say. That thing is there in the mind. That is vasana, in other words, vasana. So, samskara purvaka hi smruti icha prayatnadayah. Smruti means, what is this smruti? It is that samskara which you are recalling. You have eaten some rasagulla in some place, and then that nice experience is there. So, that rasagulla has produced that smruti, or that samskara. That samskara of rasagulla is now recalled. So, that becomes smruti. Then again you desire, and then again you go to that, that shop, and then you again eat it. So, that is prayatna. All these things, they are because of this mithya pratyaya only, and not, they are not atma gunas. The basic point is, what is atma guna and what is anatma guna? Then, smruti icha prayatna adayah. Okay. Yatha asmin janmani, deha adi sanghata abhimana ragad dvesha adi krutau, dharma dharmau, तत्फलानुभवश्च तथा अतीते अतीततरेपि जन्मनि इति अनादिः अविद्याकृतः संसारः
इति अनादिः अविद्याकृतः संसारः
अतीतः अनागतश्च अनुमेयः
अतीतः अनागतश्च अनुमेयः
सो ही सेज ह्यूमन बीइंग हैज ऑलवेज बीन इग्नोरेंट ही हैज बीन इग्नोरेंट ऑल थ्रू जस्ट एज यू आर हैविंग सम मिथ्या प्रत्यय इन दिस लाइफ Just as you are identifying, say, your body-mind complex with the Atma, just as you are saying this, just as you are now saying that this body-mind complex is the Atma, you have been saying all through, even in earlier life and life prior to that, and in all lives, earlier lives, you have been saying that only. So that is what he says. Yatha, just as Asmin Janmani, in this life, Dehadi Sanghata Abhimana Raga Dveshadi Kurtav. Dehadi Sankhata Abhimana. Abhimana means the notion of I, Aham Pratyaya. Dehadi Sankhata Abhimana means this Aham Pratyaya in this Dehadi Sankhata body mind complex. Dehadi Sankhate Ahamity Abhimana. So this I notion, the notion of I in this body mind complex, just as you are doing in this life, and then because of that, Abhimana, Raga Dveshadi Kurtav. And because of this notion of I, there is a Raga and there is a Dvesha. And because of this raga dvesha, you have done some dharma and adharma, dharma dharmau, tat phalanu bhavasya, and you have also got the experience and you have got the fruit and experienced it. And similarly, tatha means in the same manner, atite means in the past life, atita tara, and much prior to that, one life prior and another life prior to that, atita tara, atita tama, you can go behind like that, atita tarepi janmani iti. Anadihi avidyakrutaha samsaraha. This samsara is something which is anadi. It has been coming up without beginning. It has no beginning. That is, it is beginningless. It is coming on from that time onwards. Avidyakrutaha samsaraha. Atitaha anagatascha anumeyaha. Atitaha anagatascha. All things which are past and all things which are going to come, this samsara has to be anumeyaha. Anumeyaha means Anumanena jnatavyaha, that is to be inferred. Anumeya, Anumana is that pramana, Anumana is pramana. Anumeya means something which is known by that pramana, by Anumana is Anumeya. Something which is known by pratyaksha is pratyaksham only. Something which is known by Anumana is Anumeya. Something which is known by Upamana is Upamiti. So something like that. Anumeya. अनुमेयः ततश्च सर्वकर्म संन्यासात् ज्ञाननिष्ठायां आत्यंतिक संसारोपरमः इति सिद्धम् सो वन कंक्लूशन इज हियर सिद्धम् व्हेनेवर ही सेज सिद्धम् मीन्स इट इज प्रूव्ड दैट इज सिद्धि दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच इज प्रूव्ड व्हाट इज दैट ततश्च देयरफॉर सर्वकर्म संन्यासात् ज्ञाननिष्ठायां इन दिस ज्ञाननिष्ठ That constant abiding in that state of awareness. What? And also associated by this Sarvakarma Sannyasa. Sarvakarma Sannyasat. Because of this Sarvakarma Sannyasa, then again leading to Jnana Nishtha. Because of that, Atyantika. Atyantika means complete, without leaving anything. Atyantika, without leaving anything. Atyantika Samsara Uparamaha iti Siddham. Atyantika means assured, samsara uparamaha, the whole samsara gets withdrawn. It is siddham, that is what is proved. Avidyatmakatvaccha dehabhimanasya. Avidyatmakatvaccha dehabhimanasya.
Avidyatmakatvaccha dehabhimanasya.
Tannivruttau dehanupapattehe.
Tannivruttau dehanupapattehe.
Samsaranupapattihi. So because this dehabhimana, what is it due to? It is due to avidya. Avidyatmakatvaccha dehabhimanasya. This dehabhimana itself is avidyatmakam. Avidya is its nature. Avidya atma yasya. So that avidya is the self. Avidya is the self of this dehabhimana. So that is the point. Tan nivruttav. Once that avidya is gone. Tat nivruttav means, what is that tat? Tat means avidya. Avidya nivruttav. Deha anupapattehe. Once avidya is gone, then there is no deha. So this man is freed from this cycle of birth and death. Then deha anupapattehe samsara anupapattehe. This samsaranam. Samsaranam means transmigration. The transmigration is avoided. Anupapattehe. Anupapattihi. Then deha adisanghate.
Deha adisanghate.
Atma abhimanaha.
Atma abhimanaha.
Avidyatmakaha.
Avidyatmakaha.
Is again rephrasing it. सो देहादि संघाते इन दिस बॉडी माइंड कॉम्प्लेक्स आत्माभिमानः दिस नोशन ऑफ आई इज समथिंग विच इज अविद्यात्मक इट इज ड्यू टू अविद्या देन नहि लोके गवादिभ्यः अन्यः अहम् मत्तश्च अन्ये गवादयः इति जानन् तेषु अहमिति प्रत्ययम् मन्यते कश्चित् one who knows that okay all this gavadibhyah anyah aham so you are aware that you are totally different from all these cows and bulls which are there in front of you you are very much aware and then similarly gavadibhyah anyah iti janan mattasya anye gavadayah those things are different from me I am different from them they are different from me iti janan knowing that a person who knows that तेषु अहमिति प्रत्ययम् न मन्यते कश्चित् दिस् न हेज़ टु बी कनेक्टेड् देर् नहि नहि दट् नहि हेज़ टु बी कनेक्टेड् देर् तेषु अहमिति प्रत्ययम् सो इन् दोस् कौस् एट्सेट्रा यू डोण्ट् से ऐ एम् दट् अहम् प्रत्ययः यू डोण्ट् डेवलप् अभिमान इन् दट् गौणाभिमान इट् इस् ओके बट् देन् वी आर् नौ टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् द गौणकर्म रिसल्टिङ्ग् इन् मुख्य फलम् गौणकर्म गौण प्रत्यय कर्म इज गिविंग इन मुख्य फलम सो यू कैंट इक्वेट इट लाइक दैट सो तेषु अहमिति प्रत्ययम् न मन्यते कश्चित् नोबडी थिंक्स दैट आई एम दैट कौ देन अजानंस्तु स्थाणौ पुरुष विज्ञानवत् अविवेकतः देहादि संघाते कुरियाद् अहमिति प्रत्ययम् न विवेकतः जानन् ओके अजानन्स्तु अजानन् मीन्स् वन् हू डस् नाट् नो अजानन्स्तु बै नाट् नोयिङ्ग् अजानन् प्लस् तु अजानन्स्तु इफ् यु क्लब् इट् इट् बिकम्स् अजानन्स्तु ए पर्सन् हू डस् नाट् नो वट् डस् ही थिङ्क् स्थाणौ पुरुष विज्ञानवत् So now it is not a question of two different things which are perceived. It is something which is not properly perceived. Sthanav Purusha. Sthanu Purusha Dushtranta. You see, Simha and Manavaka, those two things are very clearly known and deliberately you are making a statement. That is a figurative statement. Here it is not so. Here it is due to Ajnana. Here the example should not be, the comparison should not be between Simha and Manavaka. It, the comparison should be like that Sthanu and Purusha. In some semi-dark condition, you are seeing something and then mistaking for a human being. So, like that. So, here, Ajanansthu, Sthanav Purusha Vijnanavat, just as in the case of a person imagining a human figure in the place of a Sthanu. Sthanu means some sort of stump. Avivekataha Dehadi Sanghate Kuriya Dahamiti Pratyayam. Avivekataha. It is because of this lack of discrimination, lack of, ultimately we are coming to this Viveka, Atmanatma Viveka. So Viveka, when Viveka is absent, then only Dehadi Sanghate Kuriya Daham Pratyayam. A person does this, he will develop this notion of I in this Dehadi Sanghata only because of lack of discrimination, lack of philosophical understanding. न विवेकतः जानन् नाट् बै नोयिङ्ग् नाट् बै विवेक वन् हू डस् विवेक ही विल् नाट् डू लैक् देट् देन् यस्तु आत्मा वै पुत्रनामासि इति पुत्रे अहं प्रत्ययः स तु जन्यजनकसम्बन्धनिमित्तो गौणः ओके यस्तु But on the other hand, you are referring to this Atma Vai Putranamasi, that is, O man, you are living in the, not name only, in the form of your son. Namna means awesome, not merely by the name, in the form. In the form of your son you are living, if you say like that. Putre Aham Pratyayaha, this notion of I in the son, it is something gauna, because of Janya Janaka Sambandha Nimittaha. That is, Janya means something which is born, son. Janaka means father. Janya Janaka Sambandha means the relationship of father and son. Janya Janaka Sambandha Nimittaha Gaunaha. Janyam means, Janya is something which is born. Janaka is that which produces is Janaka. That means instead of saying producer or something like that, you can say father and son simply. So the relationship is that of the father and son. It is gauna. It is basically figurative. Then gaunena cha atmana.
Gaunena cha atmana.
Bhojanadivat paramartha karyam na shakyate kartum.
Bhojanadivat paramartha karyam na shakyate kartum.
Gaunasimhadibhyam.
Gaunasimhadibhyam.
Mukhyasimhagnikaryavat.
Mukhyasimhagnikaryavat.
You see, gaunena cha atmana. You see, you are saying, okay, he is my atma, he is myself. Suppose he eats food and you don't eat food. So, what will happen to you? So, bhojanadivat paramartha karyam na shakyate kartum. He will eat food and he will be happy, but you will starve. So, with that gauna atma, with this gauna self, with that figurative self, bhojanadivat paramartha karyam na shakyate kartum. This paramartha karyam, the real karma cannot be done by gauna pratyaya. So paramartha karyam has to be done by this man only. He has to eat food. Paramartha karyam na shakyate kartam. Then gauna simha agnibhyam mukhya simha agni karyavat. So this gauna simha and gauna agni, this devadatta and manavaka, he cannot do the job of mukhya simha and mukhya karma, mukhya agni. Then the Purvapakshi comes with another small explanation. Adrushta Vishaya Chodana Pramanyat.
Adrushta Vishaya Chodana Pramanyat.
Chodana Pramanyat.
Chodana Pramanyat.
Atma Kartavyam.
Atma Kartavyam.
Gaunaihi Dehendriyadibhihi Kriyate Iti Chet Na.
Gaunaihi Dehendriyadibhihi Kriyate Iti Chet Na.
Okay. This. Anyway, these are all, Purvapakshi still insists, anyway, what all we are doing is Atma Pratyaya only, Atma Kartavyam only. It is the duty of the Atma, Atma Kartavyam. Atma Kartavyam, and how do you say that? Pramanyat, Shastra Pramanyat, Shruti Pramanyat, Adrushta Vishaya Chodana Pramanyat, because Shastra is something which is guiding you. Chodana means motivating, driving. Actually, it is driving, urging, motivating. It is driving you in all matters, in all adrushta vishayas. Adrushta vishaya chodana pramanyat. Because of that, it is pramanam. Adrushta vishaya chodana pramanyat means shastra, which is pramanam, because it is motivating you or directing you in matters which you do not know, in matters which are not directly seen. Adrushta. Adrushta means not directly seen, isn't it? Something which is unseen. In all these matters, what is pramana? Shruti is the pramana. Shruti says, okay, there is some heaven there. You do this yajna. So you perform this yajna. Taking Shruti as the pramana, taking Shruti as the authority. You have not seen it. You have not seen Svarga. Isn't it? So that is the point. Adrushta Vishaya Chodana. Chodana means directing, motivating. Because of that pramanyam, Atma Kartavyam, whatever has to be done by Atma, Gaunaihi Dehendriyadivihi Kriyate. You see, Dehendriyadivihi, by this Deha and Indriya, these are Gauna, these are figuratively Atma only. By these things, it is all this Atma Kartavyam is being done. Whatever these things do, they are really speaking Atma Kartavyam only. So that is what Purvapakshi says. Whatever this Gauna, Deha, Indriya, body mind complex does, is indeed that of the Atma only. So that is what he says. Iti chetana. Then avidya kruta atma kartavya atma katva avidya kruta atma katva tesham
avidya kruta atma katva tesham
na gauna atmanah dehendriyadayah
na gauna atmanah dehendriyadayah.
So this, you can't say that dehendriyadayah, they are not there. You can't say that they are gauna atma. Gauna atma means figuratively they can be called atma. You cannot say like that. Then avidya krutatma katva tesham. All these things are due to avidya only. This deha, mithya, what is this? Deha, indriya, this body mind complex has evolved only because of avidya. All these things, this aham pratyaya is there because of avidya only. So you can't call this dehendriyadi as gauna. Na gaunaha, gauna atmanaha, dehendriyadayaha. They cannot be called as gaunatma. Then katham tarhi.
Katham tarhi.
Mithya pratyayena iva
asangasya atmanah sangatya
atmatvam apadyate
आत्मत्वं आपाद्यते
तद्भावे भावात् तदभावे च अभावात्
तद्भावे भावात् तदभावे च
अभावात् सो कथं तर्हि मीन्स् हौ वाट् एल्स् वाट् देन् हौ वाट् हौ एल्स् डू यू एक्स्प्लेन् देन् ही इस् एक्स्प्लेनिङ्ग् मिथ्या प्रत्ययैः नौ ही इस् अगेन् यूसिङ्ग् द वर्ड् मिथ्या The Purvapakshi is saying it is all Gauna, whereas Siddhanti says it is cannot be called Gauna, it is false only. Mithya Pratyayai, Mithya Pratyayena Eva, Mithya Pratyayena Eva. It is only because of this Mithya Pratyaya, it is only because of this wrong perception or false understanding that Asangasya Atmanaha Sangatya, this Deha, Indriya, etc., these are all very proximate to this Atma. Very proximate to Atma in what sense? A stone is not proximate to Atma. Whereas Indriyas and then mind, etc., they are proximate to Atma. Why? Because mind is supposed to be a virala taijasa dravyam, achya virala, atyachya virala taijasa dravyam manaha, that's what Vedanta Parivasha says. Mind is that so, such a fine thing, that it is capable of taking the reflection of that Atma. Chaitanya, Atma Chaitanya, it is capable of taking the Chaitanya. And then a little bit of it, say, is taken by the Indriyas. A little bit of it is taken by the body also. So the body also appears to be something similar to Chaitanya. We had come across something like that in the earlier passage, that beautiful words, I forget. Antahkarana takes the reflection in the sense, in that, if you use that simile, then something of it is taken by the Indriyas. Something of it is taken by the body also, and then that is the proximity of this body-mind complex to the Atma. And because of this proximity, you are, what are you doing? You are equating it. Where is this katham tarhi? Mithya pratyayenaiva, asangasya atmanaha sangatya. Sangatya means because of this proximity, because of this closeness. Sangati. Sangati means closeness or proximity. Atmatvam apadyate, you are superimposing, you are attributing atmatvam on, anatma. You are attributing atmatvam means the certificate that it is atma, that is atmatvam. The status of atma, you are attributing the status of atma on dehendriya sanghata, which is anatma. Dehendriya sanghata is anatma. You are putting a stamp on that as Atma because of Mithya Pratyaya. So, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Mithya Pratyaya Naiva, Asangasya Atmana Sangatya. And why is it you are doing? Because this Dehendriya Sanghata, this body-mind complex is so close, so proximate to Atma. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Then, Tadbhave Bhavat. Yeah, Tadbhave Bhavat, Tadabhave Cha Bhavat. Tadbhave means Mithya Pratyaya Bhave, Tat, please, you can note down as Mithya Pratyaya Bhave, Tad Bhave Bhavat means Tat refers to Mithya Pratyaya. Tad Bhave Bhavat, so only when you have got that Mithya Pratyaya, that notion of I is there, and then when that Mithya Pratyaya is gone, Tad Abhave means when that Mithya Pratyaya is gone, Abhavat, that notion of I also disappears. That notion of I disappears, is there when you have Mithya Pratyaya. When Mithya Pratyaya goes, then that notion of I also goes. Is it clear?
Yes.
Then
Avivekinam hi.
Ajnana kale balanam. Drushyate dirghoham gauroham iti.
देहादि संघाते अहम् प्रत्ययः भवति तस्मात्
मिथ्याप्रत्ययाभावे अभावात् तत्कृत एव न गौणः. ओके अविवेकिनां हि इट इज ओनली बिकॉज इट इज ओनली इन द केस ऑफ अविवेकिस ओनली इन द केस ऑफ दोस हु डोंट हैव दिस सेंस ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन हु आर दे अज्ञानकाले बालानां बाला मीन्स नॉट नेसेसरली बॉयज बाला द वर्ड बाला कैन रेफर टू ओल्ड पीपल आल्सो those who are not trained in the shastra are called bala. Bala does not refer to child, young man. There is a line in Tarka Shastra, bala means anya shastreshu se panditopi asmin shastre apanditaha, something like that. There is a definition there. Natu stanandhayaha, bala does not refer to stanandhayaha. Stanandhayaha means a milk sucking baby. He is not a milk sucking baby. He may be an elderly man. Anya shastreshu panditaha, he may be a pandita in anya shastras. No, this is not the definition. I am just telling in my own words. There is the much better words are there. In all other shastras, he may be a pandita. He may be a great physicist, he may be a great chemist, he may be a great scientist or mathematician. But in this shastra, he is a pandita. So in this shastra, he is called bala. So that is the bala. So avivekinam hi ajnana kale balanam. So for all such balas, for all those, you can say, grown-up children, we can say grown-up children. Yeah, that is a better word. For all such grown-up, some people we say, this fellow is like a grown-up child. So like that. So for all such grown-up children, drushyate dirghaham gaurohamiti pratyaha. So in such people only, we see dehadi sanghate aham pratyaha. Such people only, they say, I, and refer to this dehadi sanghata. So, natu, and not in the case of vivekinam, not in the case of those who have this sense of discrimination. Anyaha aham dehadi sanghata aditi jnanavatam. Jnanavatam means those who know. Jnanavan, jnanavatam. Jnanavatam is shashti bhavachanam. So, for those who know that I am different from this body-mind complex, those people, then tatkale, dehadi sanghate aham pratyaya na bhavati. This na has to be connected to that. So this aham pratyaya, this notion of I in this body mind complex will not happen. Then tasmat mithya pratyaya bhave abhavat. So when this mithya pratyaya, this false understanding is not there, aham pratyaya is not there. When mithya pratyaya is not there, aham pratyaya is not there. So that is why it is says that tatkruta eva na gaunaha. Tatkruta means mithya pratyaya kruta. So that understanding is something which is attributable to mithya pratyaya and not to gauna pratyaya. It is clear? The Purvapakshi wants to say that it is all gauna pratyaya. Siddhanti says it cannot be gauna pratyaya. Gauna pratyaya, you can use that word in the case of Simha, Manavaka. You can't use it in the case of Sthana Purusha. So that is the point. Then Pruthak yes, he is further explaining the same thing. Pruthak Gruhyamana Vishesha Samanya Yorhi.
Pruthak Gruhyamana Vishesha Samanya Yorhi.
Simha Devadatta Yoho.
Simha Devadatta Yoho.
Agni Manavaka Yorva.
Agni Manavaka Yorva.
Gauna Pratyaya, Gauna Pratyaya Shabda Prayoga Va Syat.
Gauna Pratyaya Shabda Prayoga Va Syat.
Na Agruhyamana Samanya Vishesha Yoho. So, Gruhyamana, Agruhyamana, we have seen. Gruhyamana means something which is perceived. Agruhyamana means something which is not perceived. Pruthak Gruhyamana Vishesha Samanya Yoho. When this Samanya and Vishesha. Vishesha means the uniqueness. Samanya is generality. So, what is the uniqueness of Simha and the uniqueness of boy? After all, Simha is a Simha, it is there in the lion, it is there in the forest, it is pouncing on other animals, tearing up and then eating. This boy, what is his uniqueness? He goes home and eats some chapati or something like that. So Samanya, what is Samanya? Ferociousness, Kraurya. This boy also, he also eats some chicken or something like that and then he is also Krura. Kraurya Samanya is there, Samanya, that similarity is there. But uniqueness also is there. So there is a Vishesha and Samanya. Pruthak Gruhyamanaha. Pruthak means separately, differently. Differently they are identifiable. Pruthak Gruhyamana Vishesha Samanya Yorhi. Only in such case where this uniqueness and similarity are separately perceived. Only in such cases, like Simha Devadatta Yoho, Simha Devadatta, like in the case of Simha and Devadatta, or in the case of Agni and Manavakaha, Gauna Pratyayaha Shabda Prayogo Vasyat. You can use that gauna pratyaya, you can have that gauna understanding, or you can use that word shabda prayoga va syat, gauna shabda prayoga, you can use that word gauna, figurative usage you can justify there, but not in the case of na agruhyamana samanya vishesha yoho. Where that samanya and vishesha are not seen, as in the case of sthana purusha, you can't use this word gauna. Is it clear? Yattu uktam.
Yattu uktam.
Yattu uktam. Yattu uktam shruti pramanyaditi.
Shruti pramanyaditi.
Na.
Na.
Tat pramanyasya adrushta vishayatvat.
Tat pramanyasya adrushta vishayatvat.
And you also said shruti pramanyat. Okay, shruti also is saying. Shruti is adrushta chodana vishayatvat. Shruti is, that's what he was saying, isn't it? Shruti is also telling about all this adrushta vishaya, and then Shruti is asking about so many karmas. After all, Shruti also is telling about, it is the Shruti which is saying about karmas. Shruti is telling about karma. Then later in the middle level, it is telling about some upasana. So that slowly this fellow comes from the level of karma to upasana. And slowly from that level of upasana, he will come to jnana. So Shruti has got a plan of action. It has got some first level, second level, third level. So it is preventing a man from going astray and doing all irregular deeds. So it is prescribing some karmas. Then that is, that itself is not the ultimate. So then again it has to, it is say, telling about some upasana, maybe ahangraha upasana, any upasana, some other upasana. Then there itself you should not be stuck. You have to come to the level of jnana. So that is why it is telling about jnana. So there is a plan of action. There is some sort of schedule, or there is some sort of syllabus in that Shruti. So that is what he says. Shruti pramanyaditi na. Tat pramanyasya.
Tat pramanyasya.
Adrushta vishayatvat.
Adrushta vishayatvat.
So Shankaracharya is now making a very important policy statement. Shruti is talking about some adrushta vishaya. Tat pramanyasya. Pramanyasya means of the pramanyam of that Shruti. That pramanyam is in the case of adrushta vishaya. That is something which is unseen, like Swarga, something else, some other loka. So it refers to some adrushta vishaya, Shruti refers to some adrushta vishaya and not something to drushta vishaya. Pratyakshadi pramana anupalabdehi vishaye.
Pratyakshadi pramana anupalabdehi vishaye.
Agnihotradi sadhya sadhana sambandhe.
Agnihotradi sadhya sadhana sambandhe.
Shrutehe pramanyam.
Na
pratyakshadi
vishaye.
Adrushta darshanarthatvat pramanyasya. So pramanam is something which is adrushta darshanartham. If you translate it into adrushta darshanarthatva pramanyasya, if you translate into ordinary Sanskrit, pramanam adrushta darshanartham. This pramanam is there in order to know what is not physically seen. So that is the ultimate thing. So let us see the first portion. Pratyakshadi pramana anupalabdehi vishaye. In something where this pratyakshadi pramana. Pratyakshadi means pratyaksha, anumana, etc. All these pramanas, anupalabdhi means they are absent. Anupalabdhi, we should not take it as anupalabdhi, another pramana. Pratyakshadi pramana anupalabdehi vishaye. In a context where this pratyakshadi pramanas are unavailable, where you are not able to directly see something, then he is again further explaining. Agnihotradi sadhya sadhana sambandhe. There is what is called sadhyam and there is what is called sadhanam. Sadhyam means a goal, sadhanam means a means. So agnihotradi sadhya sadhana sambandhe, something which is connected with this agnihotra, etc., where agnihotra is the sadhanam and you are achieving a sadhyam called swargam. So in such cases, shruteha pramanyam. Shruti is very much pramana. Shruti, because we have not seen heaven or hell. So shruti, you have to jolly well listen to that. Na pratyakshadi vishaye, not in the case where you are directly seeing, not in the case where something is known directly. Na pratyakshadi vishaye. Adrushta darshanarthatvat pramanyasya. So this pramana is only in the case of adrushta adrushta vishaya and not in the case of drushta vishaya. Tasmat na drushta mithya jnana nimittasya aham pratyayasya. Dehadi sanghate gaunatvam kalpayitum shakyam.
Dehadi sanghate gaunatvam kalpayitum shakyam.
So this is the point. This mithyajnana, aham pratyaya is due to mithyajnanam. Aham pratyaya is due to mithyajnanam. That notion of I is due to wrong understanding, and this is something which is drushta vishaya. It is something which is directly seen. तस्मात् न दृष्टमिथ्या ज्ञान निमित्तस्य अहम् प्रत्ययस्य दिस अहम् प्रत्यय इज बेसिकली ड्यू टू मिथ्या ज्ञान एंड दट इज दृष्टम इट इज वेरी क्लियरली सीन सो इन सच केस न देहादि संघा दिस न द बिगिनिंग न हैज टू बी कनेक्टेड हियर न देहादि संघाते गौणत्वं कल्पयितुं शक्यं सो वेन यू आर वेरी क्लियरली सीइंग मिथ्या प्रत्यय यू कैनाट विजुअलाइज गौण प्रत्यय Gauna relation when the mithya relationship is very directly seen, the Gauna relationship you can't visualize, you can't explain in that manner. Dehadi Sanghate Gaunatvam na kalpayitum shakyam. Gaunatvam you cannot advocate in the case of Dehadi Sanghata. Is it clear?
Yes.
This particular line.
Yeah.
Then here makes a very, very powerful statement. Nahi Shruti Shatamapi. शीतः अग्निः अप्रकाशो वा इति ब्रुवत् प्रामाण्यमुपैति ब्रूहि ब्रूधात् ब्रू दट इज सेयिंग अटरिंग ब्रूहि नहि श्रुतिशतमपि ईवन इफ यू टेक 100 श्रुतिस And 100 Shrutis say Agni is cold, fire is cold. Suppose 100 Shrutis say Agni is cold, the fire is cold. Or like, fire is not giving any light. Fire always gives some light. Nahi, Shruti Shatamapi, Shitaha Agnihi, Aprakashova, it is not giving light. If it says Bruvat, if it says so while saying so, na Pramanyam Upaiti, it cannot be accepted. It cannot be accepted as Pramana. When Shruti says so, then what else? You can't reject the Shruti also. You have to see what is the context and what is it that Shruti is having in mind. What does the Shruti want to say? Vivaksha. Vaktum Iccha is Vivaksha, isn't it? What is the Vivaksha? What is the Vivakshitam Artham? So Shruti may say something, but what is the Vivakshitam Artham? That we have to see. That is what he says. Bruvat na pramanyam upaiti. Yadi bruyat. यदि ब्रूयात् शीतः अग्निः अप्रकाशो वा इति तथापि अर्थान्तरं श्रुतेः विवक्षितं कल्प्यम् प्रामाण्यान्यथानुपपत्तेः न तु प्रमाणान्तरविरुद्धं स्ववचनविरुद्धं वा यदि ब्रूयात् So if at all Shruti says like that, Yadi Shruti hi Bruyat, if it says like that, what? Shitaha Agnihi, Aprakashova. Suppose Shruti says Agni is cold, then it is not giving any light. If it says, Tathapi, even then, Arthantaram Shrutehe Vivakshitam Kalpyam. Shrutehe Vivakshitam, that is, what exactly is the intention of the Shruti? Vivaksha. Vivakshitam means what is the intended thing? Arthantaram, some other meaning, kalpyam, it has to be thought of. Some other meaning has to be thought of. You know, keeping in mind what exactly is the Shruti saying. Shrutehe vivakshitam, what exactly is the intention of the Shruti? So, arthantaram kalpyam, you have to give some other meaning to that word. When it says Agni is cold, you have to create some other meaning. Some other, you have to give a different interpretation. So, that is the meaning. Pramanyanyathanupapattehe. Otherwise, that Shruti is Pramana cannot be established. Shruti also cannot be rejected. Shruti cannot be rejected and Shruti cannot be opposed also. And Pramanyanyatha Anupapattehe. It cannot be opposed to Pramana and you can't reject Shruti also. That is the position. When that is so. Natu Pramanantara Viruddham Swavachana Viruddham Va. Kalpyam. Kalpyam as Kalpyam. That is, You can't visualize or you can't give an interpretation which is pramana viruddham. There is something which is seen pratyaksha. You can't say that Shruti is saying like this. This is not life. This is not. Suppose I see a pen in front of me. Shruti is saying it is not a pen. So I can't take it as pramana. I have to see what meaning I have to give to Shruti. So this is a very, very important policy statement by Shankaracharya. Where Shruti has to be interpreted in accordance with Yukti. Shruti, Yukti, Pramana, isn't it? So, logically, Pramana also cannot be rejected. Shruti, Yukti and Pramana, they have to go together and one has to support the other. So that way. Na pramanyanupapattehe, na tu pramanantara viruddham swavachana viruddham va. And so Shruti, you can't say Shruti has told something in one place and something in some other place. Swavachana viruddham means contradicting one's own statement. Shruti has told something here and something there. You can't say that it is self-contradicting. So you have to see what is the correct meaning. You have to see that eka vakyata. What a beautiful line it is. We'll continue in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.